Professional football is a contact sport. There are tackles, there are collisions, there are moments of skull-quivering intensity. But the measure of a football player's heart is not just what he brings to those moments on Sunday afternoons. It is what he brings to the quieter moments between those hits and tackles, and what he brings to his life after he's done with all of the collisions. Ronnie Lott brought his best. Ronnie Lott brings his best. He was born in New Mexico and played his high school and college football in Southern California. With USC, he won a national championship and played in two Rose Bowl games. But in 1981, when the 49ers drafted Lott as a defensive back, he moved to the Bay Area and soon made a decision that would one day affect his life and the lives of thousands. He developed a fondness for Santa Clara County and made his home here, while being a defensive trigger switch for a 49er team that would cast aside losing and morph into a Super Bowl champion with vicious intensity, an intensity that originated from Lott himself.
I'd say from the first day Ronnie Lott arrived at Rockland at training camp, maybe he and one other player are the only two that ever were pros from day one.
And really from the very first snap in the very first game, he laid an identity, and that identity soon became the face of the defense.
Lott played cornerback and safety the way that Mozart played the piano, with pounding crescendos and intelligent grace. At training camp, he roomed alone so that he could study his playbook without distraction. His enthusiasm for the game was ravenous. He once said he would practice at 3 a.m. if the coaches asked. Lott played with broken bones and sprained knees. He had part of a finger amputated in order to miss less playing time. Late in each season, due to pinched nerves in his neck, he needed help to put on his shirts after each game. But he always played. And under Bill Walsh and later George Seifert, Lott was the defensive fulcrum in four Super Bowl victories.
Ronnie was so intent. And knew and had a sense of timing during the course of a ball game exactly what to do to help us win a ball game. He's a great competitor.
Early on in Lott's time with the team, he made a determination to use his name and fame to fill the gaps between games with an outreach effort to the less fortunate people in the area. By then, the 49ers had moved their year-round practice facility to Santa Clara, so Lott went about convincing others to follow his lead and find causes to champion.
It was all new to all of us then because we were all so young at all of it. And he was a part of establishing, not just being a part of this community on a professional level on the field, but really actually being there himself and giving of his time.
He always talks about exhausting life. And you see that it's probably easier to understand an example out on the athletic field where somebody just plays till exhaustion, but to have that translate into everyday life, like what does that mean? And Ronnie tries to set that example where he's constantly pushing, constantly trying to do more for people, for his family, and just wanting to make sure that at the end of the day and at the end of his career, like in football, people will recognize him for giving it everything that he had.
The charities for which Lott found time were numerous and wide-ranging. Many had nothing to do with sports, but his primary focus eventually became the All-Stars Helping Kids organization that he founded in 1989. It rallied professional athletes to raise money for disadvantaged youth. And 20 years later, after growing into a national organization, it continues to support children in the South Bay and beyond.
Growing up with a single mother, I did not have the resources to go to a private school. So being able to go to a private school, like you said, where people like Ronnie and his foundation are able to sponsor financially, has made this a reality for people who live below the poverty line, like myself, and haven't been able to get a shot at a goal and be in college.
We provide almost $1 million to organizations throughout the Bay Area and nationally on an annual basis. We meet with the beneficiaries and provide them with technical support. Ronnie's involvement as a board member, I would say he's one of the more hands-on board members that I've seen, and is always willing to visit a school, talk directly with the students, and inspire them to achieve.
Lott left the 49ers in 1991 and went on to play for three other NFL teams before retiring. He was inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame with the class of 2000. Yet he never abandoned his permanent residence in the South Bay. And today, it would be difficult to find a cause in Silicon Valley that he has not helped support, and impossible to overstate the difference he has made in the lives of so many young people.
If Ronnie was sitting here right now, I would like to tell him that I am proof that kids who would have easily fallen into the temptation of the streets and headed the wrong direction have made it in life. Ronnie has opened new doors for students like myself. I'm thankful for him and for the few other people who are like him, who have had such great success and have never forgotten to give back to society. He is a role model to me, and I hope to be in the same situation one day to help those kids in need the same way I was helped when I was growing up.
He's one of the few people that if he tells you something, if he tells you he's gonna do something, no matter what it cost him, and I don't mean monetarily, no matter what it cost him, he's going to do it. And he's going to be there for you because he said he would. And so to have a friend who set that kind of example of what it means to give someone your word and stand behind it, he's still leading the charge.
Ronnie Lott was not born in Santa Clara County. He did not play his college or NFL games in the South Bay. But for his ability to elevate an entire valley's altruistic conscience, he has more than earned his spot in the San Jose Sports Hall of Fame. After he left the 49ers and was playing his first game against his former team, Lott said, "It's tough to do. No one can ever measure my respect and admiration for those guys in that locker room. Tonight, in this room, the respect and admiration is for a man who never stopped hitting hard, or in the moments between and after those hits, never stopped sharing his heart."